Welcome all for yet another video on Dr. RS and you, science of cosmetics and personal care products. Today we will be discussing part 34, fats and oils, key quality parameter. So we have seen 32 parts of all the various aspects of the science. Part 33 was a review, where it was a recollection of all the things we have covered and a brief on what we are going to cover. Please go and look into part 33 also. Thank you. So part 34, fats and oils, key quality parameter. Fats and oils are widely used in cosmetics, personal care products and cosmeceuticals. Certain terms which I wish you all to get familiarized, all these terms are used, will be used frequently in the following chapters, and some of the aspects will be applied while developing a formulation, right? So just I want to introduce those aspects to you, right? So part 34, fats and oils, key quality parameter, part 34, right? So what are the parameters we are going to discuss? Acid value, sap value, free fatty acid, ester value, hydroxyl value and iodine value. These are the aspects which we will be discussing, right? So first, the acid value, right? What is the acid value? So the acid value is the number of milligrams of potassium hydroxide required to neutralize the free fatty acid present in 1 gram of the substance, right? For example, stearic acid is a fatty acid. So everything there is a free fatty acid, no? It's a fatty acid. Same way, oleic acid, lauric acid. So the stearic acid, the acid value is 195 to 199, oleic acid 198 to 204, lauric acid 278 to 282. This is stearic acid, C18, lauric acid, C12. These are all oleic, linoleic, alpha linolenic. So these are all C18, but they have single bond, double bonds, triple bonds, no? So these are all the various fatty acids, right? So now, what it means, 1 gram of stearic acid, see, if you take the acid value as 198, so 1 gram of stearic acid requires 198 milligrams of potassium hydroxide for complete neutralization. That is what it means. The acid value is number of milligrams of potassium hydroxide necessary to neutralize the free fatty acid present in 1 gram of the substance. So this is the milligram required to neutralize 1 gram of the substance, milligrams of potassium hydroxide. While calculating the acid value, this might be important. 56.1 is the molecular weight and equivalent weight, same for potassium hydroxide, right? Simple. Then the second thing is sap value. What is the sap value? The saponification value is the number of milligrams of potassium hydroxide necessary to neutralize the free fatty acids and to saponify the esters present in 1 gram of the substance. These are all the vegetable oils, and of course this is not vegetable oil. Beef tallow and of course lard is not vegetable oil. Most of them are vegetable oils. Butter, so rapeseed oil, corn oil, olive oil, soybean oil, cocoa butter, right, linseed oil, all these things, coconut oil, palm oil. See, these are all the sap values for those oils, right? These are all the sap values. What is this? What are vegetable oils? Chemically, what are vegetable oils? Vegetable oils are esters only. What esters? They are triglycerides. They are triglycerides. This is the triglycerides. Sorry, again, there is marking here. Okay, all the markings. See what happened? I did the recording once, the entire thing, but I found I have not started the video, so I am doing it again. So doesn't matter, it's a revision for me. So these things, this is a triglyceride. All vegetable oil is a triglycerides of fatty acids, right? This is R, right? This is stearate. So coconut oil has all fatty acids saturated, and palm oil also saturated, but others, olive oil, they're all, they have unsaturated fatty acids. We'll come to that now. So this is fatty acids or triglycerides. So when it reacts with potassium hydroxide, what it forms? It gives RCOOK. What is this? This is soap and glycerin, right? This is soap and glycerin, right? This is glycerin and this is soap. Now, if you store these vegetable oils under certain conditions, right, they can get hydrolyzed, right? And some free fatty acids are also present in that case. Or some of the butters, no, cocoa butter, natural butters like cocoa butter, shea butter, have free fatty acids in them and also esters. So now, what is sap value? Sap value is not only the potassium hydroxide reacting with the esters, but also whatever free fatty acid is neutralized by potassium hydroxide. For example, acid value, no? RCOOH. Let us say that free fatty acids are also present. Potassium hydroxide will react and form RCOOK. So sap value is potassium hydroxide required to saponify the esters and also to neutralize the free fatty acids. That's also here. So now, what is saponification? Saponification is any reaction that ends up with the formation of a soap. RCO, fatty acid with potassium hydroxide, is also neutralization, but it's also a type of saponification reaction because soap is formed. Here, triglycerides of fatty acids. Right? These are all vegetable oil. They also react with potassium hydroxide. Glycerin is the byproduct, but soap is the main product. Right? So this is also saponification reaction. That is, so number of milligrams of potassium hydroxide necessary to neutralize free fatty acids present in the substance and also to saponify the esters present in saponify the esters present in 1 gram of the substance. Right? This is also an ester. No, this is cetyl palmitate. Right? Cetyl palmitate, an ester between cetyl alcohol and palmitic acid. Alcohol and an acid forms an ester, right? So cetyl alcohol and palmitic acid forms an ester, cetyl palmitate. So this also, there will be a sap value, right? Because it's an ester. So now, here, this will have, okay. Now, this is very clear. Now, what is free fatty acids? Okay, now you have a vegetable oil. We know that all the contents of the vegetable oils are triglycerides, but there can be some hydrolysis, or it's a very old oil, there can be traces of free fatty acids in that. So if that is calculated, that's called free fatty acids. See, free fatty acids are produced by hydrolysis of oils and fats. The level of free fatty acids depends on time, temperature, moisture content, and the oils and fats exposed to various environments such as storage, processing, heat or frying. So free fatty acids are formed. So now you take the vegetable oil and see the acid value of that. That is the free fatty acid. That acid is not supposed to be there. So that is called the free fatty acids. Free fatty acids of vegetable oils will tell you the quality of the oil. No, it has to be practically nil, right? Free fatty acids. Then there is a other concept, ester value. What is ester value? Ester value is SAP value minus acid value is equal to ester value. We saw here, right? SAP value is neutralizing the free fatty acids and saponification of the esters, right? This is the acid value. This is the SAP value, right? So SAP value minus acid value. So SAP value, this is SAP value, this is acid value. SAP value minus acid value will give the esters present. I told you cetyl palmitate, if there are no free fatty acids in this complete reaction, it will give whatever is present will be esters, because here there will be a SAP value and ester acid value, SAP value, acid value will be zero. Then SAP value becomes the ester value, right? So if there is no free fatty acids, SAP value will become ester value. No acid value in the product, the SAP value become the ester value. If this is 150 and this is 5, the ester value will be 145. That's a simple calculation, right? This is the ester value. Then there is another term, hydroxyl value. The hydroxyl value is the OH group. How it is formed? It is reacted with the acylation agent, which acetylate this hydroxyl group, and the excess acetic acid is titrated, and from that you find the hydroxyl value, right? That is the test method. So now castor oil 160, cetyl alcohol, stearyl alcohol, lauryl alcohol, sorbitan monostearate, emulsifier, this has 235 to 260 hydroxyl value. These are all contributes to the hydroxyl value, right? Here I want to point one thing to you. Castor oil is the only oil which will have a hydroxyl value, minimum 160, because castor oil has ricinolic acid, which has one, the fatty acid chain has one OH group, okay, and this contributes to the hydroxyl value, okay. So castor oil should have a minimum hydroxyl value of 160, because that ensures that level of ricinolic acid is present in castor oil, which is characteristic of castor oil, right? So if you take coconut oil or any other oil, you will not get the hydroxyl value, because hydroxyl group is not there, right? So some of the emulsifiers, sorbitone monostearate, sorbitone monolaurate, sorbitone monooleate, right? Glyceryl monostearate, all those emulsifiers have typical hydroxyl value, right? So this is the hydroxyl value. Then iodine value. The iodine value is the number which expresses in milligrams the quantity of halogen calculated as iodine, which is absorbed by 100 grams of the substance under test condition. Okay. Now, iodine value gives the extent of unsaturation. Extent of unsaturation in the fatty acid. Okay. See, this is stearic acid. It is totally saturated. No double bonds, so it will not have any iodine value. But oleic acid, double bond is there. Linoleic acid, two double bonds. Alpha linolenic acid, three double bonds. So you can see coconut oil and palm oil has very low iodine value. Actually, the iodine value of these things should be less than one. Some contamination, you get these iodine values. Actually, iodine value should be less than one for coconut and palm oil. See, for sunflower oil, 125 to 140. Groundnut oil, 84 to 100. Sunflower oil has very high level of linolenic acid, right? Three double bonds. Sunflower oil. See, we said linolenic acid. See, polyunsaturated fatty acids are good for the skin because they aid in the development or synthesis of ceramide lipids, right? We were discussing when we were discussing on ceramides, moisturization. So, polyunsaturated fatty acids called PUFA. You have heard about PUFA? PUFA is polyunsaturated fatty acids. That's PUFA. Okay, these are all polyunsaturated fatty acids. This is mono. These are all polyunsaturated fatty acids. Right, so they are good for the skin. What happens now when polyunsaturation is there or little unsaturation is okay, polyunsaturated especially, they become rancid because this group can be attacked by oxygen, peroxides can form. If the peroxide value of this oil is high, tending towards rancidity, because rancidity means you get very typical smell from the oil. Old vegetable oils, especially sunflower oil, groundnut oil and all, you get that sesame oil, you get that smell, right? Rancid smell. Coconut oil and palm oil, you will not get that smell. So mostly coconut oil and palm oil are used for making soaps, right? And there is a caution. If you use sunflower oil or olive oil and all those oils, especially in a lotion containing oil and water, right, an emulsion, you have to be very, very careful because even at low levels, they become very rancid. You can see within 2-3 months, if it is a warm weather, you could see a different smell. The perfume is lost and you get a different smell in the product. So when you use these things, you have to use adequate quantity of antioxidants to protect it from rancidity. Right? If it is a 100% oil-based product, a hair oil, so there also you have to put antioxidants, but there the rancidity is little less. But if it is an emulsion, a body lotion, with these oils, you have to be very, very careful because rancidity can set in very fast. So that is in the formulation angle. This is iodine value. This is what I wish to discuss with you today. So I was a little fast, but I think that it was useful to you. Any doubts, you can always write to me in my email, and I will get in touch with you in the next session. Till then, bye, take care, be safe.